And there goes a motorcyclist here on Sunday, July 13th. I'm sorry, June 12th, 2016. So on my return trip to Pyeongtaek, I wanted to stop at this rest place and check it out. And it's not really a rest place per se, it's a trail or a, it's a parking spot I saw before, but never really did anything with. So now I just want to take a few minutes to explore. Because that's how things work here. My schedule is so busy that I don't, you know, I have to maximize my time. So when I return, go to Yongyang, come back, I like to take a few minutes and check out places like this. So it's nice, it's lush, it's green, it's full of litter. How nice, right? So Korean. Let's see how we can make the best of this. Now, full disclosure, I was already here just a few minutes ago, so I'm taking the camera now and making a video of this. Because this is, it's cool. There's some cool stuff here. It's one of the things that makes this place appealing. And I know some people are curious about Korea, and other things are just downright frustrating. So let's go with the cool stuff first. The cool stuff is this. Not the trash. I really don't understand these people's obsession. All those little stories you've heard about Asia and nature and stuff. Nah, it's not true. Man, never seen anything like this in America. But anyway, back on target. So let's go down these steps here. Got a little creek running through here. It rained here today, which is wonderful because we need it. And right here, you have like one of these natural springs that'll run from the mountain to the stream. And then they in Yongyang on the east coast, my other place where I live, we have quite a few of those. So what you would do is, if you're interested, you would take like this and just simply drink it straight from that. And it's supposed to be pretty safe and all. I've never had a problem with it. In fact, I was here washing my face with it just before I got this camera. Uh-oh. There goes that. Let me get down and get that. I'm trying not to get dirty, so I'm trying not to kneel. It's a little more difficult. Okay. There we go. Great. Now it fell again. Let's try this again. Good. Stay. Alright, so if we go from here, what we're going to do, let's just go up here for a little bit, see what's up. I don't have much time. I got to get back and get ready for work and everything tomorrow. But while I'm here, let's have some fun. Because I love nature. But I don't love plastic bottles in nature. In those ways, I'm an environmentalist. Oh, and I should point out, let's go back to this little natural spring here. You got this cute little sign here. Ane Moon. Like information. I think moon means like gate or door, you could say. I'm in Jincheon right now. Jakhap. I really can't translate all this. So I'm in Jincheon Goon. But I'll let you at home have the fun of reading all this and translating if you like. If I go over here, this is going to lead up somewhere, but I don't have a lot of cutting tools with me, so I'd have to play Hackmaster. That means getting really sweaty, really wet, and getting bitten up all these little chiggers and stuff. We're not going to go that way. I don't have the clothing nor the desire to do a major hike. Or an expedition, I should say. And I'm really trying to avoid getting like super sweaty. So we're going for the low-hanging fruit, the easy stuff. That's what I like to do on these trips. So let's go up this way. Let's change that around. So we got some stuff here. make sure there are no spiders, because this is an ideal place for them to make their little webs and stuff. Nothing there. Look how green that is. You can hear the rain dripping off. You can even see it. It's beautiful. I love weather like this. Nice and lovely. Whew. Oh, I wish we had eucalyptus around here. That'd be really sweet. Or sassafras, I should say. We don't have sassafras here either. I heard that's up in Seoul, far from me. Kind of cool. So a trail like this, we have quite a few of these in Yeongyang. These are old trails. Hunters would use them in Yeongyang, like it would go up to those ridge lines. Or probably it's either going to circle around, go to those tombs, or B, if I went the other way, it would lead there. But let's go here real quick. Then I'm going to give you a little travel tip on dealing with tombs and in the mountains. That over there. It's kind of nice, right? Get up there. Got little mosquitoes jumping around, not mosquitoes, insects jumping around. If we're quiet enough, we might find some good animals. Got there. I need to take a photo of that and examine it when I get back home. And take a picture of the tree and the bark. That's always important. Got some wild berries here, raspberries. You know, not when they're all mutated or mashed up like that, they're not good, but when they're just fully ripe, if you will, they're good, and they're safe to eat. I eat the wild raspberries and strawberries here all the time, whenever I can find them. A little trail there, but for simplicity on this hike. We're gonna go here. All right, check this out. Over here, it's a tomb. It doesn't look like it's well maintained. It's like they made it and just deserted it, so somebody forgot to maintain it. It's kind of a big deal in Korea, because they're into ancestral worship and all. But look over there. See, look at that. Somebody's like tore up that new ground. That's new ground right there they tore up for this. I think I saw that driving up here. See, there's another one right there. Oh, I'm trying to get this rock here. Maybe I was thinking it was an old like tomb or had an inscription on it. It doesn't. Okay, I'm going to circle around this tomb. And I'm going to give you a little travel tip. This will help you in Korea in your land navigation. Let's go here real quick. What's that little bad boy? Let's get a nice picture. Alright, now, I know this is easy, this is pretty easy trail, but here in general, check this out. Let's say you're hiking in the woods, you're in the mountains, especially for the casual people visiting here, and they're just not good at it, they don't do it enough. to navigate and you find yourself lost, all right, understand this. I actually understand two. Number one, trails like this, yes, I said it could be used for hiking and hunting, but they often are used to go to landmarks, or I should say those tombs, these burial sites. So what you need to do, or understand, is if you find a trail like this, it's going to lead probably to someplace like this. Then, if not, it'll lead to someplace, okay? And if you find yourself at one of those tombs, that means there's a trail nearby. That's the key. If you find yourself at a tomb, that means there is a trail. Why? Because when making these tombs, the average person is not trying to make their life difficult. Ah, sawtooth oak. Yeah, that one looks like a sawtooth oak bush. It's not a tree yet. That'd be a place to get some acorns later. But anyway, so when you're walking here, like I said, and sorry I'm repeating this, there are trails leading to these places. Why? Because when they constructed this, they're not trying to make it difficult. They're actually trying to make it easy for themselves. Bodies had to be put up here. That material had to be put up. It had to be buried. And then they got to maintain it. See how that's let's zoom in here. See how it's maintained over there? Look at that. All right. So they want to make this easy as possible. Oh, wow. I think that's another one over there. Let me zoom in on that. I don't have a steady cam. Sorry. Nope. That's just regular rocks. My bad. So if you find a place like that, you have the satisfaction of knowing, like, hey, there's an exit nearby. And all you gotta do is look for a trail near that area, and it's gonna lead down. You know, depending on how well they maintain it. See, there's another sawtooth oak tree right there, or oak bush, as I like to think of it. But it's gonna lead down. And look at me right now. I have to use this right now. I know to go down, but I'm thinking, hey, how do I get down? Because I've been so busy filming and stuff. Where's the trail? But I can see there's a trail right there. So I'm gonna try to get down this without falling on my butt, because I really just don't want to get dirty on this little adventure. Well, oh, there I am sliding. Okay. Ta-da, we're making our way down. Let me slow it down and zoom out, right? I didn't realize I had that on, sorry. There we go. These beautiful trees and everything here. The beautiful landscape up here, it's beautiful. Down there at the bottom, ugh. All right, maybe not as beautiful as I thought. Still. That was pretty crazy. It's gonna get. Sounds kind of negative, doesn't it? But I just really hate pollution. I just really hate seeing garbage everywhere. Right there, there's like another trail. And I could take that trail. What do you think? What do you people think? Should we do this? Should I go do this or not? Let me go down here first. I see where it starts. It starts right there. Oh, I know what this is. This is the trail. It's going to circle. I bet you it's going to like circle. I'll probably leave those tombs over there. Because right down there is a gully or a ravine. So that would be difficult. So the trail was made to circle around it. It's kind of funny the amount of effort and everything they really do put into these like tombs and stuff. It's a lot of work, a lot of stress. But on the bright side, at least for you or for us, the hiker, you at least get a chance to come out and enjoy nature and, you know, it's a paved trail, more or less. So let's just push forward a little bit further. Then it's time for me to get back home. Ooh, vine there. Check that out. Hold on. nice photo of that. I need to research that later. See, look at this. What's all this? You would think it was like corn almost. You're like not ripe, you know, growing. All right. So now look at this trail. This is require a little bit of hacking for me to go up there. And I'm in tennis shoes with low socks, and I'm attracting mosquitoes because I'm sweating wet now. So I'm not going to go that way. I'm just going to turn back and go to the car. Get back on the road. But that's your little, just a little view of camp, you know, hiking here. Side of a road, you wanna call it a pit stop. That I was always curious about. So, maximizing my time, I stopped. Took about maybe 20 minutes total by the time I get back to the car to do this trip. And remember what I said. You find yourself lost in the mountains. You don't know what to go, where to go. Look for these, grave sites. Tombstones, grave sites, whatever you want to call them. Oh, we got a little scat right there. Looks like deer scat. That's probably rabbit. There are a lot of deer here. In fact, if I slowed down, fine. But anyway, back on target. I do get a little distracted in these videos. You look for that, you will find a trail exiting out, and that trail is going to lead down. Why? May not be next to the road, but they want simplicity. They're gonna make it as easy as possible. So there's no need to panic. In fact, next time I get a chance to go back to Yung Yung, I wanna try to get up in the mountains and make a video about how to find game trails and stuff to navigate with. It's really cool. When you know where animals are, like the trails the animals take, it helps in your land navigation skills. But that's a whole separate topic. And a whole different video. But anyway, so down the hill I go. Doo, 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 doo. You can see the road right there. Look how close this is. Man, I think it's kind of cool that you can drive in a place like this and just stop on the side of the road and you got these trails to go hiking and exploring. And I'm sure there'll be a lot more cool stuff here if I had a chance. Or I should say more time. To explore would be really nice. There's some information there. I think it just irks the kimchi out of me though, is all this just litter, man. What's up? It's hard to understand the thinking of people. I didn't just flat out laziness and complacency. Unfortunately, sinful human nature. But I'm gonna shut this camera off because I don't want to film these people and I don't want to deal with them. So you all have a great one. Thanks for watching. Out.